I now invite Henry Sunil to talk on the topic, talent more than perseverance leads to one's success.
Good morning, everybody. Respected Principal Father Anthony Madonakar, Vice Principal Ms. Vinitha Mentis, my dear teachers, and my fellow Heartians. Well, I'm Henry Sunil, and I'm from 12D. And the topic given to me is nothing but talent more than perseverance leads one to success. So, before coming to the topic, I have a question to you. You all know who is Lalatan, right? So which is his best film now currently popular? Yeah, we know it's Lucifer, okay? I mean, like, what is so special about him? Sorry? Okay, you may have varying answers, right? Okay, fine. You know, there is a kind of relation of Mohanlal with mathematics. Do you know what's that? Okay, it's a very interesting question. If you don't know, we can go to Heidi ma'am. Heidi ma'am, in the back, I think she's there. I have a simple question to you. What's the relation between Mohanlal and maths? Ma'am? Okay, do you have an answer? Okay, I'll tell. Okay, fine. We draw 45-degree angle, right? Yes? With using a protractor, right? So, what is special about Mohanlal? This is special about Mohanlal, right? Right? So, there creates a relation of Mohanlal with mathematics, right? Okay? And we are familiar with Mamuka also, right? Yeah. So what's the best dialogue he had ever told us? Okay, there are many, but can you just say? Okay, leave it, I'll just say. Raja Solingar the same, Sena Mattada Sol. You know why he's touching our hearts? You know why? His determination, his perseverance, do you think? No, it's all because of his talent and nothing else. There are many people in the film industry, especially in the Mollywood industry. But when you just come, only two people come to your mind, right? It's none other than Mamuka and Lalatan, right? Okay, now let's come to the definition part. The worst part which you don't like. Even when you deal with anything, we have to deal with the definition part, right? So let's move to the definition of talent. So when you come to the definition part, talent is an inborn quality that gives us the achievement. So it is largely determined by genetics and early childhood environment. So, you may have certain inborn talents. Different kinds of talents are present within you, right? Okay, how many of you have talents? Let me see. Raise your hands. How many of you have talents? Okay, fine. Only this much? So you have got talent. What about you? What's your name? Okay. You don't have talent? You think you don't have talent?
I have talent.
She said she's having talent. I don't know why she didn't raise her hand. But it's okay, it's fine. Okay. Choose for talent, not experience. We know about many disruptive leaders who have made the history with their talents and not with experience. The best example? Mark Zuckerberg, a Harvard dropout, had no experience prior to building Facebook. What about the genius Albert Einstein? Many of them said many of his quotes, so I'm just referring to him. He had many creative skills and experience. But do you think it's responsible for the success? Do you guys think? No. He achieved the breakthroughs in his life with the oceans of talent, right? And then, coming to the football world, which is the best football player or players? Okay, fine. I just can't hear just Ronaldo and Messi. Why? Modric is playing football. Harvey Jingen is playing football, standing in the back, controlling the ball. Why? Aya Sahel, don't you know his name? Why? Because these names are specified that they have an inborn talent within themselves. And that makes special. And that's why their name is still in our minds more than any of them. So, it's ICC World Cup cricket, right? Yes. Who's the captain? I can still hear Dhoni somewhere else. Okay, Virat Kohli and Dhoni are the two players that you would like to tell, right? Ah, yeah, even Rohit Sharma is there. Okay, just three players you think they are playing? There are still a lot of players left. So what is the difference? It's the inborn talent that makes the difference, right? Okay, now I want you to think of a very tough situation where you are put in as a leader. You may have experience in teaching, but if you do not act mindfully, the situation may cause you to panic. Friends, here acting mindfully to take the right decision is your inborn talent. Remember, you can have perseverance. Skills can be taught, but you cannot have the talent which is not there. Do you plant trees? Okay, it's Environment Day coming. Just think about that. Okay, we plant trees, right? Okay, seed is very important for its growth, right? Seed is responsible for plants, right? Do you know what this seed is? The seed is your inborn talent. And the plant is you. You have existence only if you find the talent inside you. And then, coming on to various research works, which you don't like actually. Okay, I'm just referring here. Gallup had a research and told that the mantra of great managers is this. People don't change much, so don't waste time trying to put in what was left out. Instead, try to draw out what is left within him. Friends, try to draw out what is left within him, which is his inborn talent. Let me use a simple example to make it clear. Typing, you know, right? Typing, that boring one. Typing. Oh, computer students, where are you? Typing. Okay, leave it. Typing is a skill, right? Yeah, it's a skill. How to type is developed based on experience, isn't it? But what to type is based on the inborn talent within you, right? So it's talent which makes a difference than perseverance. So in creative fields, we need talent more than perseverance. For example, no matter how much you read or write, you cannot produce a masterpiece like God of Small Things. Even if you are not talented, and if you do not know to tell great stories, you may still become a great story writer, but not a master story writer, which is, of course, again, the same inborn talent. So let me once again emphasize and say that talent more than perseverance leads one to success. After all, success is only a journey and not a destination. Thank you. Well, coming to my introduction part, for those who doesn't know me, my name is Henry Sunil, and I'm from 12D. Okay, I'm just a fresher. I just joined the institution just 1 year back. So many of them said that they are here for 12 years. So which means it took them 12 years to realize the surroundings. But I am telling you, it just requires 1 year to understand you, understand the minds of the Heartians. So Heartians, won't you vote for me? Right? I do expect your support and valuable vote. Thank you so much.
Andrej, will you please pick a question? So Henry's question is helping family, society, or world more important? And why?
Okay, that's a very relevant question these days because we know the current generation is running out of moral values. So we definitely have to think about such things. So family is the smallest unit in the society, right? Right? So whatever we begin from smaller units, it leads to bigger units, right? So we have to start helping from the basic level. We have to help the family. We have to give importance to the family. Automatically, it gives benefits to the society and to the entire world. That's what my personal opinion is. Help your family, give benefits to them. Automatically, as a group of families comprised of society, by caring for our families, for others' families, society becomes good. We do care for society. By caring for everybody, the whole world will be great to live for. Thank you. Have a blessed day.
Thank you, Henry.